Hey everyone, Michael O'Brien here, and today I'm going to talk about how to table hop in a buffet. Hey everyone, Michael O'Brien, thank you so much for checking out this video. I very recently started working at the San Manuel Casino here in San Bernardino. And they actually hired me because their buffet lines were getting really long and really out of control. When I say long, I mean wrapping all the way around the casino floor itself. And in many cases, the guests waiting to enter the buffet were waiting like an hour to 2 hours standing in line. It's gotten so bad that they've actually decided to do a reservation system where they actually make people get in line to make a reservation to come back later and get in line again so that they can go inside. When they come back after the reservation, they're usually waiting anywhere between half an hour, 45 minutes on average, especially on a Wednesday or Thursday night because it's lobster night and it's like the craziest, busiest night of the week for them. So my job is very straightforward: to walk through the line, keeping people entertained and happy while they're waiting before they walk into the buffet. That's not a problem. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. The thing that is very difficult to do is table hopping inside the restaurant. And let me explain why. When the line is gone and it's not very busy, maybe it's a Monday or a Tuesday night, and there's nothing really for me to do outside, my job is to walk into the buffet and entertain the guests while they're inside. It keeps me busy, it gives me something to do for the guests, the casino feels like they're getting their money's worth, etc. Now, usually what the magician does is they walk up to a table right after the waiter has already taken the guest's order, entertains them while they're waiting for their meal to arrive, and then once the waiter shows up with their food, the magician moves on to the next table and then the guests will begin eating. The last thing that you want to do is really perform while the people are eating, or even worse, after they're done eating, because now the restaurant wants to turn over that table, simply meaning they want the guests to get up and leave so they can bring more guests in to sit down. And of course, the more tables are turning over, the more money the restaurant is making. So why is this difficult in a buffet? Well, the answer is simple. There is no waiter taking your order, and there is no time in between while the guests are waiting for their food. What this means is that the guests come in, they sit down at their table, they drop off their belongings, and they immediately go right up to the buffet, grab their food, come back, sit down, and begin to eat. There isn't really that kind of dead time, that waiting period where the magician has an ideal opportunity to come in and entertain the guests. So I've been doing this, this is gonna be my fifth day now, so I'm not exactly an expert, but I've come up with a little system and figured out some tweaks. I'll probably do an update to this video at some point, maybe next year, after I've been doing this for a few months already and I get a lot of experience. But I just wanted to kind of walk through the troubles that I had and the steps that I had to step over, so to speak, the hurdles I had to jump over to be able to figure out a system that kind of works for me. And I'm still kind of playing, I'm still kind of making some tweaks here and there, but I think I've figured it out, and the answer is very simple. The answer is to screen the guests. Now, when I say screen them, all I'm saying is you want to qualify them. You want to kind of find out if they're someone that's open to seeing magic or if they just want to be left alone and eat. So we're going to break this up into just a couple of parts. The first step is approaching the table. Now, when you approach the table, I'm very fortunate that I have a little badge that I wear that says I work for the casino and that I'm an entertainer. So people right off the bat, they already know that I'm an employer, an employee there, and they don't think I'm just some guy bothering them while they're trying to eat. So that helps. But what I do is I walk up to them, I introduce myself, and I ask, how is everything tasting so far? They'll tell me either everything's great or it's not so great, and they'll proceed to rattle on for about a minute why they don't like the food, whatever, it's fine. Your job is to smile, thank them so much for being there, right? Play the customer service role and all that stuff. Once they are done and it's your turn to go ahead and start speaking again, what I like to do is introduce myself as the magician and kind of plant that seed in their mind that the reason I'm there is to perform at their table. So the interaction will go something like this. Well, thank you so much for joining us. It really means a lot. I just wanted to come introduce myself, say hello. My name is Michael. I'm actually the magician tonight. My job is to go from table to table and do little magic shows for the guests who would like to see. At this point, I make a little pause, not a long, awkward one, but just a little pause as I kind of look around. I kind of shake my head. I look around at the guests and I look at their facial expressions. If they're not making very much eye contact with me and it's clearly obvious they want to be left alone, at that point, I will say something like this. So I just wanted to let you guys know that I'm going from table to table doing a little bit of magic. Okay, so if you guys have any questions, don't hesitate to just pull me over, say, hey, Mike, come over here, show us a trick, and I'll be more than happy to show you guys something. Okay, sound good? Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your meal. And I move on to the next group. I have established that this group probably doesn't really want to see anything because they're eating. Maybe they don't like magic, or maybe they just want to be left alone, or they're having a conversation or whatever. It's totally fine. But I also left the door open that if they want to see magic, they can stop me while I'm walking by. They can pull me over and I can show them a trick. So it's not like I'm just shutting them down and moving on. I'm leaving that door open for them should they choose to walk through it. Now, the other option is they do look interested. They look like, oh, yeah, that looks kind of cool. So in that case, the interaction would go something like this. So I just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Michael. I'm actually the magician here, and my job is to go from table to table and do a little magic show at everyone's table. Would you guys be interested in seeing a little something? And if they say yes, awesome, I launch into my routine. If they say no, thank you, or sometimes they all kind of look at the leader of the table. It's a weird thing. Like, you can tell people want to watch, but they all stop and they all look at like one person, and they look at this person to say yes or no, and that person might be like no. In which case, same situation, you just thank them so much for joining you, and you let them know that that door is always open if they want to have you come to their table. If they say yes, that's even better. You launch right into your performance. And the type of magic that I normally do is highly interactive. The audience is holding items, they're participating with me and stuff like that. Now, the fact that I'm working in the casino automatically rules out card magic and dice magic. I'm not allowed to perform anything with cards or dice. That's just a rule that they have in the casino. For obvious reasons, they want to prevent cheating happening at the card tables and things. I completely get that. The other thing is it rules out highly interactive magic like sponge balls or things where the audience has to directly get their hands involved and things like that, especially if they're eating crab or lobster and you look at their hands and their hands are just covered in food. And it's embarrassing for them to be like, can you hold out your hand? And they're just like, oh, my hand is all covered in lobster. So I would recommend especially if you're working in a buffet, because like I said, their hands are probably going to be pretty dirty, is to kind of look around the table and decide for yourself, do I want to perform magic for this group that I'm going to have to get them to use their hands? Or can I just kind of perform magic that's visual and they can see? Like maybe doing Professor's Nightmare. For example, I just do a little one coin routine where I produce a coin out of someone's elbow, make it vanish a couple times, do like a muscle pass thing, a couple of visual moves with it. And then I say, but you know what? I'll let you keep this as a souvenir. I just do a retention and I pretend I put it right back on their elbow. I show my hands empty and they usually laugh at that and they think it's fun. One thing I've actually been performing a lot in the restaurant, and you might think this is really weird, but I've actually been doing book test. I've been doing the Zanman book test. I've been carrying around a copy of Great Gatsby with me. And for a couple of reasons. Number one, because look at me, right? And number two, because it has that whole like, look, we're back in the 20s and all that stuff. And so it's a nice little lead in. It feels natural that I'd have that book on me. Doesn't feel contrived or like random or weird, right? So I take out the book test and I can perform, read a few people's minds, and I can move on to the next group. And the guests don't have to touch the book at all, which is the best part. I can flip through the pages. I can hold the book open for them. They can read it. All that stuff. So it's visual, it's good hard-hitting magic, but it doesn't require them to touch anything, right? Now, if you are gonna perform magic that someone has to touch, like a sponge ball routine, for example, you're gonna wanna pick the guest to help you that is very clearly eating food that isn't gonna make a mess and get all over their hands. Like, don't go to the table that's eating crab or lobster and try to perform for them because they're gonna have stuff all over their hands. But if someone is just eating like something with a fork and knife, like a steak or, I don't know, like fillet of fish or whatever, right? That's totally fine. I would ask, you know, would you mind to hold out your hand for me and do like maybe one or two things at the most that require them to have to get involved with their hands. Again, this is to avoid embarrassment, and it's also to protect your props from getting all dirty, because I don't want my sponge balls smelling like seafood when I get home. It's already bad enough that kind of smells like cigarettes a little bit because of the casino. but you don't want them to be touching your props and getting everything all dirty. You'll have to wash everything as soon as you get home and all that good stuff. Plus, they're eating, you know, so the less that they really touch things while they're eating, the better in general anyway. But I digress. The last thing that you can do, and this is actually a suggestion made to me by a good friend of mine, Micah. He suggested to go to the table, to use an item that's at their table, do something fun and visual with it, and then let them keep it as a gift. So maybe borrow a dollar bill from someone, fold the dollar bill up and make like a little dollar bill ring, and then give them that back, and then, you know, they can keep that, they can wear that on their finger or whatever. Maybe make a little rose out of a napkin, float the rose, and then hand it back to them and let them keep that as a little souvenir. That way, it's something quick, it's something visual, they feel like you're not really bothering them too much, and it leaves something at their table that they can take home with them. So, all in all, it's not that bad, it's just different. You have to find different ways to kind of engage your audience and things like that. And the traditional, you know, walking up to a table and performing when the server has taken their order thing all kind of flies out the window. But anyways, I wanted to thank you guys for watching this video. Do you have any ideas? Do any of you guys work in a buffet? Or do you have any questions for someone that might work in a buffet? And I go ahead and leave this discussion open in the comment section here. I always encourage discussion. I don't want to just talk at you guys. I want to hear what you think as well. And I kind of want to get your creative juices flowing and get you guys kind of communicating with each other. Almost like the Magic Cafe, except, you know, we actually help each other instead of just like talking crap. But anyway, my name is Michael O'Brien. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you haven't already subscribed, please do so. Be sure to share this video with anyone that you think might get some use out of it. And until next time, we'll see you guys later.